equal amount of a percentage of a female hair get the hair loss with the condition called as telogen effluvium. Hello, I am Dr. Koparkar, founder Papillon Hair World. I am practicing medicine and treating hair loss patients more than 30 years. I get male as well as female patients. In this video series, we are trying to give the answers to the commonest questions asked by my patients. The commonest question which is there in the mind of all female patients is, what are the different causes of a hair fall or hair thinning and how to stop it and whether there is any treatment for this kind of a hair loss. Remember, there is a difference between a male's hair loss in a man's and hair loss in a woman's. In a male pattern baldness, the hair loss starts always from receding the hairline, and at grade 6 or 7, there is almost no hair onto the crown. Against this, the classification in women's we do by something called as Ludwig's classification, which divide the hair loss problem only in three categories. First category, most important difference between male and female, is in female there is a diffuse hair loss in the crown area. So in Ludwig stage 1, the parting starts separating out and there is a thinning which starts from the center. In grade 2, there is a almost overall diffused hair loss, but that can be hide up by styling the hair differently. And the third stage is, whatever you do, that thinning, overall thinning into the crown area cannot be hide. And remember well, nowadays female pattern baldness is seen in 50% of the patients complaining about the hair loss. And if you don't take the medicines properly or at proper time, you are bound to get more and more hair thinning and you land into the situation when the personality becomes miserable and there is a tremendous amount of a hair loss in a crown portion. This is one which is also called as a female pattern baldness, which is a diffused baldness. Equal amount of a percentage of a female hair get the hair loss with the condition called as telogen effluvium. This telogen effluvium, as I have already mentioned, is because of sudden amount of hair coming into the telophase stage, giving rise to sudden hair loss and depression of the anaphase stage. When this happens, what are the reasons of telogen effluvium kind of a hair loss? One, most important, immediately after delivery. Second, the condition which is called as PCOD. Third is postmenopausal hair loss. Remember, in all these three, the reason for hair loss is reduction into the estrogen level. Out of this, post-pregnancy hair loss, the estrogen comes back to normal and you get all those hair back. In another two varieties, in PCOD and in postmenopausal hair loss, unfortunately, the estrogen never comes back to normal and so you get lesser and lesser hair as the age advances. Another reasons for this kind of a telogen effluvium hair loss, as you must have seen, is hair loss after sudden shock, sudden mental shock, hair loss after mental stress and physical stress, hair loss after nonsense crash dietings, hair loss after acute viral fevers, and the most important, even sudden reduction into the weight or wrong diets. The most important hair loss in females, which I very commonly find, is hair loss because of the thyroid. Always remember, the unfortunate part is in hypothyroidism, means when the thyroid hormone levels are less, or in hyperthyroidism, whenever the hyperthyroidism level, thyroid levels are large, or even in the treatment of thyroid deficiency also, the medicine which is given also can give rise to hair loss. So in all hypo, hyper and during the treatment, the female can get the hair loss. So thyroid is one of the commonest reason for the hair loss in females. As far as the medication is concerned, if at all it is because of the telogen effluvium, try to give the treatment which will support their minerals, support their proteins, and try to give them a maximum mental and physical peace. As far as female pattern baldness, you can safely use 2% minoxidil into those patients along with high protein diet and minerals like zinc, vitamin A, vitamin E, or any related problem treatment associated with female pattern baldness. So this is all about female pattern baldness. If you got the answer about what are the different causes of female pattern baldness or thinning in females, I hope you will like this video, share it, subscribe it also for getting different answers to your commonest questions related with hair loss. Thank you.